What's going on today? Everybody neat and pretty?
Neat and pretty!
Then take it away!
Thank you.
Yeah, I can't wait to tell Zabu about our canoe trip.
Yeah, neither can I.
Here we are, our home away from home.
I know that part. I wasn't talking to you, Chris.
I was talking to this snail.
Wow, it's an apple snail.
Yeah, and he hitched a ride with us.
He didn't even have to leave his home. That's because a snail shell is his home.
Yeah, but there is one thing that an apple snail needs, and that is to be put back where he belongs, in the water.
With all the other snails, like this ram's horn snail. Check out his cool head.
There you go.
Okay, time to call Zabu.
Today, let's call Zabu like monkeys. Zabu! Let's do it.
Zabu!
Hey, Zabu's here!
You know Zabu. He never talks until he's finished his snack. I'll be right back.
Who'd you see out there, Zabu? Okay, I know. Food first.
Maybe I'll give Zabu a nut.
A nut has a shell. Like a snail.
Zabu, I have a nut. Zabu loves nuts. You want it, Zab? There you go. Better boy.
When a lemur isn't eating leaves or fruit, he's eating nuts.
I love nuts.
That's because you are nuts, Zabu.
You guys are nuts, too.
We're all nuts.
Nuts about creatures. So let's have some.
I saw an animal who was doing something I'd never seen anything do before. He was chewing a tree.
Chewing a tree?
Yeah. I couldn't believe my mind. Chewing a tree. Who could it be?
Thank you.
He has a tail that looks like a paddle.
He chews down trees with his teeth.
Whoa! Watch out!
A beaver!
Mongatsika! Mystery animals here!
That's him. That's the tree eater.
You want to get a closer look? Come on. Yeah, right over here. Fur is so thick. That keeps him warm in the winter.
Just like our winter coats.
Yo, yo. It's Rez on the street. What's up? Yo, blew up in here. What's up? What's up?
Beaver's feet are funnier than Martin's, even.
A beaver has great hind feet for swimming. See that skin between his toes? When you have that, you have webbed feet.
And a beaver's webbed feet help him glide through the water.
Hmm. Funny webbed swimming feet.
I can see how webbed feet are really great. Hey, but did you ever notice that a beaver's tail has scales on it, like a reptile or a fish?
An iguana's scales keep her from drying out in the sun, and she's covered with them from head to tail.
But look, a beaver's tail's all smushed. I bet a tree fell on it.
No, Zob!
That's the way a beaver's tail is supposed to look.
Yeah.
Flat, like a paddle.
His tail looks like a paddle, and my tail... doesn't look like a paddle. How come?
A beaver's tail is flat so he can use his tail to do all sorts of amazing things. Like you use your tail to do amazing things.
When he smacks the water with his tail, it makes a really loud noise.
That's the way he tells all the other beavers, danger's near.
Okay, a beaver's swimming along. He sees a predator, like a wolf. So he slaps his tail. That tells the other beavers to swim for cover.
A beaver tail slap water fight.
Look out, Zob!
I knew I'd get in the middle of this.
Here's Zob's towel.
Oh, thanks. Hey! Look! The beaver's standing on his tail! I can't believe my mind! Oh, hurry, Martin, look!
Wow!
Martin, now you're standing on my tail.
Sorry, Zob.
It's okay.
Zabu's right. There is another way a beaver uses his tail.
He sits up on it when he's chewing on trees.
Yes, chewing trees, like I said.
Or when he's eating corn. But a beaver usually eats wood and bark.
Ugh, who wants to eat wood and bark?
Not bark like a dog's bark. Bark like the bark on a tree.
Yeah, and one time I tried biting a tree like a beaver.
It's not easy with human teeth.
I won't do that again.
But we can bite corn. It's soft.
My brother's so corny.
Corny like corn.
Everybody bite like a big-toothed beaver.
Orange teeth. Mangatsika. I've never seen an animal with orange teeth before.
What about me? It's an orange peel. But a beaver really has orange teeth.
Hey, Chris, your teeth are very appealing. Get it? Appealing.
A beaver's teeth are orange because they don't have this white stuff called enamel that covers our teeth.
That's the stuff you brush every day.
He's chewing again.
He can't chew here. If he does,
he'll wreck somebody's home.
A bird made a nest here.
What a Mangatsika nest.
While he was steaming, I was steaming in the beamer, just steaming. Can't believe that I called my man cheating. So I found another way to make him pay. To Neiman Marcus on a shopping spree, and on the way I grabbed Sully and Mia. And as the cash box rang, I thought everything away. Ooh, there goes the dream we used to say. There goes the time we spent away. There goes the love I had, but you cheated on me, and that's for that now. There goes the house we made a home. There goes you'll never leave me alone. For all the lies you told, this is what you're owed. While he was bragging, the cold. What happened to the days when we used to trust each other? And all of the things I know will take you until you get home. To get them back without me, cause I'm just better than money you see.
Hey, when you really wanna get the wild, just go back and get them up the style. Now you're gonna catch it.
Is a big little creature with a huge urge to chew.
Whew, I hope he doesn't chew anywhere else.
Whoa!
Oh, you're all wet now. Money.
Nice one, Chris.
Mud baths are like jelly baths in Zabu land. So I was leap, leap, leaping along. Leap, 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 leap.
Tree.
You can't chew here. This is somebody's home.
A flying squirrel lives here, and her babies are inside the tree in their nest.
Why is he chewing out everyone's home?
Home! Home, that's it! The beaver is chewing on these trees and posts so he can build his lodge.
Lodge? Of course! I knew that. What's a lodge?
A lodge. A lodge is a beaver's home.
It looks like a big pile of sticks, but you know what? There are rooms inside.
Oh, a lodge! Does that mean the beaver's gonna build his lodge here in Animal Junction?
Well, not likely, because a beaver likes to build his home near...
Lodge.
Okay, lodge. A beaver likes to build his lodge near running water.
Oh!
You see, beavers feel safe in the water, so that's where they like to be, in the water.
And I bet they feel even safer in their lodge. But how do they build it?
Well, after the beavers chew down some trees, they carry branches to the spot they've picked for their home. Then, they put these branches into a big pile. When that's taken care of, they go underwater and chew their way through all the branches, making a hollow that turns into a cozy home.
It takes a lot of branches to build a beaver lodge, and that's why the beaver was chewing up everything.
He was looking for pieces of wood to build his home. Lodge.
I'm feeling beaverish.
Thank you.
chewed right through Animal Junction.
He's taking the paddle, yeah.
I see it.
Here's to have a beaver home. Lodge.
But guys, oh, I can't believe my mind.
What's going on, Zob?
The beaver. He took your paddle.
He took our paddle?
I bet he was using it to build his home.
Lodge.
Incoming!
Here comes Moonface.
Doc!
Hi, Moonface. Did you know that a beaver's home is called a lodge?
Hey, a message from Jackie.
Chris, to the closet!
To the closet.
They're going to the closet. They're going on a trip.
Are you ready?
They're going to the closet to grab their stuff and slip. Huh?
Yeah! And I got my goggles. And I have these web-footed flippers because most of a beaver's home
lodge
is underwater.
They're going on a cool adventure and they don't know what's in store. They're coming from the closet and they're headed out the door.
Bye, guys.
Bye, Zabu.
Zabu say beagle?
He said eagle.
It's a bald eagle.
Bald eagles are one of the largest raptors in North America.
And Martin, look what she built.
What a home! It's huge!
Hi, guys. We're bald eagles.
You're right, Zob, you are.
You bald eagles make the largest nests in the world.
And you need to, with a big baby like an eaglet. You need lots of space.
She's a bald eagle, but she isn't really bald.
That's right. She's only called bald because her head is white.
Yeah, like my head. And I'm not bald either.
Yeah, but here's a creature who really is bald. Naked mole rats. Their whole body's bald.
Oh, bald is beautiful.
She's using her beak to put the twigs where she wants them.
Hey, let's help her.
Oh, no. You gotta use your beak.
Okay.
Yeah.
Whoops. I need a little practice with my beak.
I'm gonna put mine right here.
I'll get more twigs.
Look at these wings. Bald eagles have a 7-foot wingspan.
And those wide wings help a bald eagle soar high in the sky. But eagles don't fly right away. An eaglet needs some practice. So when she's about 10 weeks old, she does a lot of wing flapping to strengthen her muscles. That gets her ready to fly.
More twigs coming up.
Hello. Nice, Chris.
Hey, can I have a twig?
Oh, it's our extent. Excellent.
All right, Zob.
Nice hoisting.
Some birds are amazing nest builders, but few are more amazing than the weaver. The weaver takes grass or whatever plants he can find and makes a basket nest for his babies. Now watch how he weaves that one piece of grass round and round like he's sewing.
And check out these termites. They're building a humongous mound out of mud and termite spit.
Hey, you know what? You know what? I helped a friend make a home once in Zabu land. I was leaping along, leap.
Thank you.
you taught the Nagandrill how to make a home.
Yeah. Well, he especially needed one. Hey, hey! Wait, where are you going? Come back!
Don't worry, Zob. She'll be back. Eagles use the same nest year after year after year after year after year after...
For 15 years.
And I liked 15 things best about today. What was your favorite part?
I liked when we found the beaver.
Hey, there's a beaver! And the beaver lodge!
And my extra favorite part of the day was eating corn with the beaver.
My favorite part was when we rode our bikes into the pond!
You guys did that?
Yeah.
Tell me again.
My favorite part was when we rode our bikes into the pond! Wow!
You guys are silly.
This animal is a friend of mine. From the tip of his nose to his farming behind. All the friends that we met today are special in their own way. We've all got different names, but we're really all the same. Thanks for dropping by, we're glad you came. These animals are friends of mine. They jump and swim, crawl, fly and climb. One more thing we have to say, go make an animal friend today.
Hey, look, the beaver's back! Think he's been chewing on anything else?
I don't know, but, Chris, your shoelace is untied.
Thanks, Zob.
Uh-oh. He must have chewed on that chair.
Yeah.
I guess the beaver's back for more wood.
Well, now I have to get back to my trees.
Okay, see you later, Zaboomafoo.
Bye, Chris. Bye, Martin.
Bye, Bonnie. See you next time.
Hey, we better get home, too.
Oh, yeah, Mom's making spaghetti and meatballs for dinner.
And you know how it is if you're late for dinner.
See you next time.
See you later, Beaver. Help yourself to whatever wood you can find.